transitioning from merely being recorded by Bodhi to being live. And now we are actually live. We're live for a special breaking news edition. Lozilla! The Lozard is getting an extra dose of lols today. This is a show that only features one story. Breaking news coming out of the Bahamas. Breaking news, ladies and gentlemen, coming out of the Bahamas. Boom!
It's amazing.
I don't know if you see it there, but there it is. A complete S.T show. That's the headline on Vice News. You could see it in the background here if you're watching a live stream, and you can also see it if you're watching the YouTube channel thingy that will be posted later.
White people panicked.
That's pretty much it. White people panicked. They all gathered to try to pretend to be a minority or something, and it's like, oh, this is tough. Oh no, this is tough. This is not gonna work.
There's pee on the ground. There's in a tent.
In a
Let me tell you a story about one time I was in a tent.
Go ahead. Give us a tent story.
I actually blame my friend. Well, my brother's friend. But he is my friend too. But I thought he peed on me.
Wow.
Because I had pee all up my back.
Nice.
So immediately when I woke, and I didn't realize until later that my dong was...
When you woke, you're woke now?
I woke, I immediately thought he is the one that peed on me until I realized that my ding-dong was tucked between my legs.
You must be very thin. Incredibly thin.
I had pissed up my own back.
Yes, you must be incredibly thin. I'll just say that I have reason to believe that. Scientific reasons to believe that you must be incredibly thin. That would make a lot of sense, actually.
I don't have much of an... Yeah, so I ended up pissing on my own back.
So this is rich millennials paid thousands for Ja Rule's Fry Fest and are now stranded on an island.
Fry Fest or Fire Fest?
It says Fry... Fire, I'm sorry. I said Fry. I fry said... Fest. You know what's a Fry Fest now, man?
Fry Fest.
It's the Ja Rule's Fry. Oh, I said it again. I can't get it out. Fire. You can see fire. It here, folks. It's spelled F-Y. So it's like the Cyndi Lauper of fire is what it is. Oh, I just waited it, didn't I?
Did
you
spell that Cyndi with a Y?
Yeah, Cyndi with a Y. C-Y-N-D-I.
Oh, that's fucking... That's
you absurd. Didn't know this? This is there one of the reasons... Illegal.
There ought to be a law.
There ought to be a law, but that's one of the reasons why I was seriously crushing on her. Did you know that I had a crush on Cyndi Lauper? I know this is totally relevant to the story. But,
I believe it.
Oh, I was totally crushing on her, man.
You have terrible taste.
Whoa. Let me go get my wife. I can't wait
You've
for
had
you to
terrible
visit.
Terrible taste in women. That's all I'm saying. You got lucky.
You're ostensibly scheduled to visit this house sometime in June, and it could be an interesting visit. And we do all have guns. Just a random that's not related to that last comment. Airsoft guns, folks. We only have airsoft guns.
Yep. So, well, I'm sharing the post now. So.
Oh, good. I can't share because I'm doing stuff. So.
Oh my God.
Make sure you share with Larry.
I'm gonna ignore that message.
You got a message?
I just got a message. I don't want to pay attention to it.
Who'd you get a message from?
Someone that never shares my shit.
Someone that never shares your stuff, but were they complaining because the show is not fun? Is too funny, or too serious, or?
Yeah, it's completely unrelated.
Oh! Somebody triggered you while you're doing a show about Fry Fest. Is that correct? So, yes. Fry Fest was supposed to be the most luxurious music festival ever. An ultra-exclusive party where really rich white people got to pretend to be Poe. Spanning two weekends on a...
They didn't get
a...
to pretend.
No. They were pretending.
They understood. They all of a sudden found themselves in the hood.
But you know what? I
in the Bahamas, so it really couldn't have been that fucking bad.
You never live like common people. You never know what common people do. You never laugh like common people. There's a line in there I was trying to get to, and I couldn't get it to you. Because you know, with one call, your daddy could end it all. You ever hear that song by Pulp, Common People? It's about
I only listen to good music.
No, well, then you should hear this song, Pulp, Common People. It's about a hippie chick, rich hippie chick who wants to know what it's like to be poor and takes up with him, and then he sings this song to her. Basically, it's like, you ain't going to know until you can't call your daddy. They could all call their daddy, see? They had daddy privilege.
They tweeted their daddy, actually.
I bet you. Well, whatever.
We got to get to some of the tweets, because I think one of the guys was, I'm going to be hiding in tent 27.
You know what? Let's get to the tweets. You got some tweets up there?
No, I don't.
Oh, okay. So William,
I couldn't find it.
So William N. Finley IV said, so Fryfest, fire. So you know what? I'm going to stick with Fryfest. It sounds better. I like it. So Ja Rule's Fryfest.
Oh, sorry. Rod Jewel's Fryfest.
Rod Jewel's Fryfest. And you think about it, really, if it would have been Fry, spelled F-R-Y-E, that would have been better.
That would have given them a clue that, they got pictures of sandwiches.
They have pictures of sandwiches.
I'm sorry, it's bread with sliced cheese. And then some salad without dressing.
So Firefest is a complete disaster. Mass chaos. No organization. No one knows where to go. There are no villas. Just a disaster tent. Wait, I don't know. Do I have my... Hold on. Hold on. I'm going to do this while the show is going on. What do I need? I need audio. How do I get sound from my computer to show up? I want to make sure. Is it audio input?
Audio output.
Okay, capture. And then I select, hold on, I got to get this, because I got a video here.
Well, it should, if you're hearing me through Skype, it should be the same device.
I don't know, let's try it. All right, hopefully you hear this. Here's the video. Do you hear it? Do you hear it, Bodie?
I won't hear it. Okay. The audience.
So, we have, you see it. Oh, you can't even, you can see it on the live stream. Go to the live stream, Bodie.
I'm watching.
Oh, there you go. That's it. I'm going to play that again. There it is. They're all just mulling around. They don't know what to do. 14 seconds of sheer hell, ladies and gentlemen.
White
sheer
people problems.
Hell. Yeah.
This is amazing.
Produced via joint ventures between rapper Ja Rule and Billy McFarland, the founder of the once-lauded millennial credit card company, Manganese. Wait, if they say once-lauded credit card company, that's a clue. Just, you know. I'm just saying.
Hey, Blink-182 is going to be there. But then they said because, you know, shit was going.
Here's a great quote here. The government or whoever is running the festival down there don't want any more people. There is no accommodations. There is no place to stay. A man's place. If you're walking around, you don't know what to hear. And this is what you hear. The government or whoever is running the festival down there.
I don't know why I got on a plane and flew here.
But he's the guy with the loudspeaker, okay? He's due to circumstances beyond our control and in line with our culture of safety, great eczema inbound complimentary charter flights for Fry Festival. I'm not saying fire. Has been canceled for this upcoming weekend. That was a spokesperson, not the loudspeaker.
As everyone is there for the weekend.
Someone fainted, and they locked us up in a room using a huge chain. Holy crap! Someone fainted, and they locked us up in a room using a huge chain at deadbolt. That is boss. I don't condone it. But
I kind of condone that.
You do. Well, of course you do. If I said it was great, you would not condone it.
In this context, I don't even think Larry would disagree. This is appropriate.
Two other attendees. Well, it depends on who's doing the locking. If they're wearing a badge,
it's a peacekeeping effort.
It's a peacekeeping effort. So it's two other attendees confirmed. People were locked in and passing out.
What the hell?
Wow.
Wow.
While hordes of people were waiting at the Bahama airport to leave, the organization sent out an email confirming the festival had been canceled Friday morning. Well, I won't read it. It adds to it. Due to circumstances out of our control, the physical infrastructure was not in place on time and are unable to fulfill on that vision safely and enjoyably for our guests. Please enjoy the chains that are locking you in at this time. We are working tirelessly. Whatever.
You don't say.
We got comment. Ladies and gentlemen, breaking news commentary from Jarul himself. No, wait. What did we call him? Rajul?
Rajul.
Rajul. That's spelled with a G, by the way. G-E-W.
That's that Italian soup. Pasta Rajul.
Rajul spelled G-E-W.
Pasta Rajul.
Yeah, but it's spelled G-E-W-I-L.
It's a sausage soup.
No. G-E-W-Y-L.
Rajul.
We are working right now and getting everyone in the island safe. That is my immediate concern. I will make a statement soon. I am heartbroken. At this moment, my partners and I wanted this to be an amazing event. It was not a scam! Whenever somebody has to say it was
it's not a scam,
and
it's
definitely a scam. Partnering with a guy who is the CEO of a once lauded credit card company.
Once lauded means it's not credible anymore.
It means the once is past tense reference, as in not current tense. As everyone is reporting, I don't know how everything went so left. He said left. He should have said left. Right. Should have blamed it on the right, dude.
Should have blamed it on the right. That was
a wrong move.
That is a political failure. Yep. Especially when you're in the Bahamas. You don't get more right than going to the Bahamas.
I think he's going to be kicked out of Black America after that. That's it for him.
I mean, what is Black America? Yeah, he's not going to make... He's out.
He's done. But I'm working to make it right by making sure everyone is refunded. Some conditions may apply. I truly apologize. Listen to this. This is how you want to apologize. Listen. Hold on. Bodhi.
I'm listening.
Bodhi.
Yes.
I'm sorry. But it wasn't my fault! That's what he said. I truly apologize, as this is not my fault. He
screamed over the microphone.
No, he all capped on that. He capped out on that.
But seriously?
He capped. He put that all in caps. Not my fault.
No way.
Yeah. Emphasis his, not mine. But I'm taking responsibility. But it's not my fault.
I wish I could be at that level of shitposting.
I know! Especially after I just ruined how many people's probably being who they are, probably their lives.
After getting thousands of dollars.
Right. I don't know how many people missed pedicures and manicures, mani-pedis that day, but I'm willing to bet that a fair number of folks will. And they'll never get that mani-pedi time back. That's gone.
No. That's gone. They had this luxurious vacation all planned out to watch Blink 182 because they can't let go of the 90s.
Oh, and he posted this today. This was at 2:28 p.m. Folks, this is breaking news, hot off the press. We're only, what, we're 7 hours late. But hot off the press for Lozilla. This is breaking
unprecedented news.
Unprecedented breaking news.
Unprecedented.
Those who did not make it to the Bahamas counted their freaking blessings.
I feel like this is what Ancapistan would be.
You think so?
I think
some guy with a microphone walking around said,
"It's not my fault."
In Ancapistan, it would be a guy walking around with a microphone.
Read Rothbard.
The government or something didn't do this right. That's what they would do. Hey, it turns out they were right about the roads. That's some effed up stuff, man.
Okay. I'm so happy about this, though. I have no sympathy for these people.
I have sympathy for everyone. And no one.
Well, that's the same thing.
Everyone and no one. You know, it depends on who I'm talking to.
If they're willing to pick up this show and pay us
to produce it. Yeah, I'm going to be honest.
I'm so sorry for
you. Yes, I'm so sorry. Or they're insects. Whatever. I could go any direction, you know. Lozilla.
Did you assume their gender?
Do you want me to?
You just said insects.
No, do you want me to?
There's asexual people, okay, Paul?
I'm asking a question. How do you want me to react to this and how much are you paying? Maybe I should start off first with how much are you paying? Because Lozilla is definitely a for-pay show, even though nobody's paid us yet, but it's definitely a for-pay show.
Actually, if you go to agora.threadless.com, you can actually buy some Napa stuff.
Yeah, you can buy some Napa stuff at agora.threadless.com.
I gotta put Lozilla on a shirt.
Bodhi can make money off of it, and I can't, so that's cool. Okay, good plan.
That money's gonna get me to My Little Pony Fest, because right now it's not looking too good.
I think... That's true. That's right.
I got EMP'd, bro.
Bodhi got EMP'd. He might not make it to... I'm scheduled to go to My Little Pony Fest in Michigan in June 22nd.
Christine's asking about my sunglasses.
He saw me with my glasses, and I'm not wearing sunglasses, and he thought, you know what? I must conform. And now that you said something, Christine, now he'll say, well, wait, no, it's cool again to wear sunglasses? Okay, I'll do it. Yeah. Yeah, that's how Bodhi rolls. But I don't blame him. I don't blame him. In the same way.
I'm going to make a note now. They're prescription. Lame. So when I wear them 24/7, it's usually because I can't find my glasses.
Yeah, when I wear sunglasses 24/7, it's because I'm a boss and I own it and I claim it and I ain't apologizing. There. How you like that?
Okay, Paul.
I would have been the guy on the megaphone. And I would have said the same thing. The government. The government.
The original description of the event was like bringing all of these artists together, and all of these fancy ass people can live in these little geodesic domes. They literally advertise it as like geodesic domes, and I'm like, what?
Well, yeah, actually, you could see it right behind them. They're not geodesic domes.
They're tents.
Geodesic tents, and you could see it right behind Bodhi. By the way, I am so glad that I got my thing fixed so that I can actually show stuff now.
Yeah, I'm glad you figured out how to just add a source.
No. I knew that part. There was a problem you had to do with Chrome. It was a glitch that you had to fix after an OBS update.
That's why Chrome isn't always the best browser. You should have at least 8 different browsers.
Your mom should have 8 different browsers. She probably does. Wait, don't let your dad watch this show.
I'll beat you up.
His dad is violent. Yeah, his dad is like, you meet him and he's like, he'll smile and he has a nice, calm, gentle voice. But while you're sleeping, all of a sudden you hear some pounding on your door and he's out there with an axe. And he's not knocking on the door. That's what you find out. You think he's knocking, but that's not knocking. That's swinging.
He's there.
Coming in. He's coming in. He doesn't need you to open the door.
You need the firewood for the fire fest.
Right. Well, the fry fest.
Fry fest, sorry.
Yes, let's get it right. So festival goers paid anywhere from $1,500 to $250,000 to stay on site from Thursday to Monday. Okay, by the way, yesterday was Thursday. It's Friday. They have already descended. It's like, I expect Piggy to emerge and be thrown down onto the rocks in the next couple of hours. Right? Right?
Yes.
Lord of the frickin' Flies here. Right? Am I right? That's that's going to happen. I don't know who Piggy is.
Basically, rich privileged scum. Yeah, the bourgeois.
And they had another wave.
Going into booked. Lord of the Flies.
There was another wave booked for next weekend. Dude, if you look at this, this is like, okay, they have the tent here. Let me see if I can blow this up a little bit. Get a little zooming in on that tenty tents. And you can see.
Look at me.
There you go. Yeah. I don't know what that stuff is inside the tent. They look like giant Xantax pills.
Xantax?
Xantax or whatever?
Xanax?
Xanax, yeah.
Xantax. You know, I don't know for the drugs. You know, I don't know for the drugs, for the drugs for which you young people do. I don't know these things.
I think they're just sandbags.
I think giant prescription drugs, pills.
Drug bags of cocaine.
Oh, they're drug bags of cocaine. That's what it is. So, and look at the bed. Oh, you can see the beds. You can see the beds and... Holy moly, could you imagine paying $250,000 to advertise geodesic domes, and you come there, and wow. But, you know, I'm sorry. I have to say that maybe the people that spent $2,000, okay, maybe I understand. Maybe you didn't do a little due diligence before you left. I don't know. For me, I probably would for $2,000. I mean, I'm pledged to spend $300 to go on a trip in June, and I'm like, okay, I got to make sure everything is right before I get there, and everything is what I think it is. For $300 freaking dollars, I can't imagine dropping $2,000. But $250,000 for $250,000
in Bermuda.
In Bermuda?
Or no? Oh, what? Sorry, Bahamas.
Bahamas. Well, Bahamas. Whatever.
Same thing.
They all look alike to me. All those islands. Is that islandist? If I say all the islands look alike, is that islandist of me?
Well, islands would look the same because by nature they're described. It's the same geographic feature, geological feature.
Several people described the scene as more like a FEMA camp than a festival.
Oh, like anyone's actually.
Go ahead.
Like anyone's been to a FEMA camp.
I was just going to say, Alex Jones was right. They're rounding us up in FEMA camps, and they're convincing us to pay for it. See, that's that extra wow that Alex Jones missed.
That's actually true.
Right. That's what I'm saying.
Oh, my. Ja Rule is the Illuminati.
Illuminati confirmed. Alex Jones' nemesis confirmed.
Buy my water filters.
You're gonna go down to Bahamas and you're gonna stay in the tents and you're gonna get gay. Well, or something. Wow. Oh no, it's frogs, but I guess it could
go to people. They got chemicals in the salad that turn the freaking frogs gay.
Actually, he's not wrong.
He's not wrong. It actually happened.
It actually happened. Everybody. It's like, I'm not an Alex Jones apologist, but he was right about the freaking frogs. I'm telling you.
He was right about the frogs.
Google Sargon of Akkad, Alex Jones frogs. Sargon of Akkad does a really good analysis of this. It's like, holy crap, he was right. Right, wrong about a whole bunch. He's still, don't worry. There's plenty he's still wrong about, but he nailed the frogs.
Thing. That's the thing with Alex Jones.
Metaphorically.
The one thing I really like about Alex, or Bill Hicks, however you want to call him.
I'm going with Alex.
Okay.
That's what he likes to call
him. I like Bill Hicks way more.
When Alex calls me, he says, no, don't call me Bill, call me Alex. Okay, Bill. I mean Alex. All right, Alex.
But he always tells you before every show or during every show, don't just trust me, look it up yourself.
Yeah, he does. But he knows they won't. See, that's the thing. It's kind of like he's calling the bluff.
He knows that a few people will. Don't take our word for it. Don't take me and Paul's word for it.
Look up the facts yourself. Look it up.
There's a link in the description.
There is no link in the description.
Oh.
Because I'm lazy. I ain't doing it either.
Google it.
I'm going to SEO tag this thing for YouTube and post it, and that's about the extent of my labor.
Just check the meta, you know what I mean? Yeah, if you don't know how to...
You can't check the meta.
You check the meta. You know, if you check the meta,
there you go. The globalist, right?
I already got you.
Globalist metadata.
You know, if I ever start to build a name, a reputation, a following, whatever, I am going to do things. And as I thought about this, I realized celebrities must do this. Like,
you're
going to
do things?
Yeah, like they have this thing, like my daughter was telling me about people with the lizards, that they lizard people. And if you look at their eyes, I would purposely do stuff like that.
Yeah, you know? I would edit it in. Just the...
Right now
you can't tell, but my eyes are blinking this way.
I can see that actually, kind of like a chameleon, kind of. Ooh, karma. Karma chameleon. Karma. You better karma, watch karma. It. Karma, karma, karma will get you. You don't want karma to get you. Watch that. Karma chameleon coming after you. Son. I have a picture of a disaster relief camp in South America, and it's the exact same thing. The geodomes are the U.S. aid relief domes. Holy crap! They are literally the U.S. aid. That's what they did. They took
that is genius.
And I mean, it's genius if you could get away with it, but they didn't. So it's not genius. It was genius up until the point it says, I get it. Up until that point, it was pure genius. And then it's kind of like the credit card company.
As soon as the white people figured it out, they're like, I know what these are.
Right. That's true.
I'm not supposed to live in these.
The geodomes
that's
are
for
the
poor people.
And everything was wet. All the mattresses were wet. They took all the luggage from the airport and put it in a giant shipping crate and drove it around. $250,000. Here's your freaking luggage. Dive in. See if you find it. Good luck.
They did. You know what?
This is beautiful.
To the event coordinators, I sincerely... I mean this from the bottom of my heart.
I salute you.
Thank you. Thank you for your service.
Really? Without them, we wouldn't even have a show tonight.
We wouldn't even have a show tonight.
That's the only reason we're doing a show is because of them. In honor of them. I use the word honor rather loosely, but...
clearly, yeah, especially after today's
event. Oh, and here you go. The tents didn't lock. I mean, this thing just gets better and better. The tents didn't lock, and the quote-unquote secure lockers promised in the promotional materials were hanging open because no one knew they had to bring their own locks. $250,000, some assembly required. For $250,000, no assembly should ever be required unless you bought a battleship. Then maybe some assembly, not a lot, just some. Maybe somebody helped you install. Well,
why didn't they even have like locks on their luggage? Don't you normally, if you're rich, you have luggage locks?
I don't know. I'm not part of the 1%. I'm part of the 99%.
Oh, that's right. You're middle class.
I am middle class. I'm actually right at the 50% mark.
Right at the 45 and a half.
Well, there is no absolute.
Wait, 45.
No. I'd be right at 50.
44 and a half.
Oh, no, 99. I'd be 44
and a half.
44.5%. No, I'd be 49 point. I don't know. I don't know for math. 48.5, whatever. Yeah, 48.5.
We're bad at math.
We're bad at the math. I don't know what I was. You know what? Because in my head, I was confusing between 100 and 99, and then it just messed everything up. Then I was like, fish.
That's
the
how the Illuminati
fish.
That's how the Illuminati gets you.
That's how the Illuminati gets you. At least
it's
one
simple math.
At least one coordinator gave up and told people just find an open tent and sleep in it. Amber Hager, a software engineer who traveled to the festival with her husband, wrote in an email late Thursday night. She added that her husband turned to locals for a small meal since neither of them had eaten that day. And bars was selling the only clean water for $4 a pop. Hey, you know what? Free market at work, folks.
Post-scarcity,
baby. Looks like she's got some sort of McYucky sandwich there. I don't know what that is.
Wasn't that one of the sandwiches? It was just bread and cheese.
It looks like it's toasted. Some flattened bread and some alleged mustard and ham and cheese and a human leg right there.
Alleged mustard. Alleged.
I got to go with alleged mustard. I didn't even say alleged ham. I could have said alleged ham.
No, but it's the alleged mustard is what will get you.
Well, yeah, absolutely, because there's a lot of nasty things that are yellow. Just going to put it out there. I mean, we talked about some of that in the very beginning of the story.
Oh, pee-pee?
Right. So Morton said she and her husband looked... Pee
isn't that yellow.
It can be. Pee-pee varies in forms and shapes and sizes.
Not if they're buying $4 water.
That's true. Fitzgerald also went back to the airport. Okay, whatever. Update. People are passing out in the airport, dehydrated and begging for food. Still waiting for a plane to arrive. I don't think this is funny. I think it's terrible to laugh at other people suffering. Absolutely terrible.
But it depends who is suffering.
Oh, okay. And then here we go. Blink 182, because Blink 182, they're like, yeah, man, we're going to rock this festival. Wait, oh, you see these tweets? Holy crap.
Let's not get on the plane.
So then this is what they sent out. Ready? What voice should I use here? I'm going to use a cowboy voice. Regrettably, and after much careful and difficult consideration, we want to let you know that we won't be performing at Fry Fest in the Bahamas this weekend and next weekend. We're not confident that we would have what we need to give you the quality of performance that we always give our fans, mainly food and shelter. Food and shelter goes a long way to help you perform. I don't know if you know this. If you're,
and I mean,
teetering right now on the edge of homelessness. So you can relate to this story, right? You're like,
no,
you know what?
I actually work.
In a couple months from now, or a couple weeks from now, a couple minutes from now, you're going to be like, yeah, this dome sounds good. Sounds real good. Even if it's got a little pee on it.
I could go for a cheese sandwich right about now.
I'd go for that.
I don't care if it's mustard or alleged mustard.
This is
give me some flavor on a bun.
Yeah. Yo. Wow. You want some flavor on a bun, son? You don't wanna ask the wrong person that. Never mind. The organizers told me they were just going to do a stripped down stage, and I was like, guys, you have these signed contracts with these artists saying that we're going to honor their tech writers and their hospitality writers. You cannot give... Oh, my gosh. Major Lazer was going to be there?
Wow.
You can't not give Major Lazer a video wall. It's literally the whole set. I like Major Lazer, by the way.
Well, wow. I couldn't tell.
Blow a kiss. I know she says... Well, she says focus, fire a gun, but I like blow a kiss. No. She says blow a kiss. I like focus. Either way, blow a kiss, fire a gun. All we need is someone to lean on. A little bit. I'm glad I'm wearing adult diapers right at that moment in time.
I'm glad. I'm just happy you're clothed this time.
I am clothed. I am clothed. I am clothed.
Clothed. Send cloths.
Send clotheds.
Send clotheds.
That's a t-shirt that you can get, by the way, at Agora.
Yeah. agora.threadless.com/design/send-clothes.
Or just go to agora.threadless.com, and then you have an option to look at all these designs, and you can find it that way.
All right. I have well over 50, 60 designs.
You're going to overwhelm them.
I know.
Okay, young man.
There's over 41 products and 93 different colors, so enjoy.
Wow. So I mean, I don't know who... Oh, here's a nice picture here of a showing the tent city surrounded by a rather imposing gate that's sure to keep out intruders.
What would have been nice is if they gave all the locals machetes.
Okay, so here. Oh, yes. Just to see what happens. Just to see. You know, here, some machete. We're not saying anything. No, don't say. Hey, guys,
let's
look.
Let's just reverse the roles.
No, locals.
See what happens.
We found these machetes. And I think that they're using some sort of chemical attacks against their own kind. So I don't know how you guys... Huh?
Why does that not surprise me?
Well, right, exactly. So the chemical attacks, by the way, they're getting high. So you could say they're chemical attacking each other, and then they could Syria them. The locals could Syria them. You don't want to be Syria'd.
No. You know? When those tomahawks come down on the town that
you do not want that main. Yes. You don't want that. The festival seemed to come out of nowhere last winter when hundreds of so-called Instagram influencers, like former Pepsi spokesperson, there you go. Here is the Kardashian Jenner clan. I knew they had a connection.
I have a spoon.
I has a spoon.
I have a spoon.
I had a spoon.
I
have
a
pineapple. Spoon pineapple.
I had a margarita with dinner.
I'm having a drink right now of cran grape.
I have to be up early tomorrow. I have to be up at 8.
Why? Saturday. Ready, right? Saturday. What are you doing Saturday?
There's no weekends anymore, man. Weekends aren't significant. I'm in the hustle now.
You're becoming a capitalist. You're becoming a slave to property laws.
No, I'm becoming desperate. That's the word.
And desperation produces property laws. Fear of the other produces property laws. I'm just making stuff up, folks. None of this makes any sense.
None of this makes any sense. This has nothing to do with our real life.
Message me after the show and say, "What do you mean by that?" I don't know. It's just I put words and then stuff happens and.
Go watch our other shows. If you don't know what we're talking about, go watch our other shows.
I'll tell you what. If you want to see, though, when we're really serious and we're really experts and we know what we're talking about.
Go watch the Scooby-Doo Chronicles.
That's exactly. We pulled out our serious journalistic minds for that one.
Investigative reporting.
We put all our serious stuff in that. This is nothing.
The Hanna-Barbera conspiracy.
Oh, yeah, right. They're
taking our children. Seems to me they're taking our children. Kind of. Are you okay with that?
You're kind of making fun of it. I don't know, man. Oh, let's watch. Okay, you can't hear it. Maybe. Oh, man, you can't hear it. I'm going to play the announcing for the Fry Festival.
I'll pretend.
The actual experience exceeds all expectations and is something that's hard to put into words. All these things that may seem big and impossible are not. It gives people that type of energy, that type of power.
Wow. Holy wow. I want to go. I want to go.
This sounds like anarchy.
Amazeballs! I wanna go! Wow! The best in food, art, and music! Wow!
I'd like a cheese sandwich.
A cheese sandwich?
Could I have some more cheese, please?
Get in your tent! Get in your tent!
Been out of chains.
Wow. Well,
I'm so happy they gave us this. I can die a happy.
Oh, this is incredible. A quest to survive. To push beyond the boundaries of basic decent living. To learn how to drink your own pee. Wow. Limited availability. Wow.
I have totally drank my own pee before.
I have to say that it did not happen as advertised. Oh, wow. Model and festival promoter, Radikowski is in hiding.
And Ratatouille.
Deeply.
Ratatouille.
Oh my gosh, she made her debut in the film Gone Girl. Oh, she's gone now. She's gone, girl. She's never going to come out. And she's never going to come out of the Gone Girl status at this point. Whoa. Several artists signed to her brother-in-law, Kanye. Dude, Lolzilla has mentioned Kanye in every single episode, and that streak is alive and well today, because there it is. Several artists signed to her brother-in-law, Kanye West record label, were listed. So this is Kanye's gig too, man. Kanye is tied to this.
Christine has a bit of advice for you. I wish I would have kept that bit of advice. Please, Paul, keep your day job.
That hurts. That really hurts.
She didn't say that to me because there isn't one.
This is my day job, Christine. Okay?
This is day job is like night job.
This is my day job. This is the only job I have. This is it. I get paid in likes and shares.
Our 4 views every show support us.
Support us. Support both of us together. Yeah, they support Bodie's addictive Soylent hot habit. And
yeah, I actually had to cancel my subscription to that.
No way.
Yep.
Oh, that has to hurt.
Well, I have enough stockpiled. So.
All right, and we have. Well, hold on. We have a closing marks, and then we're done with this story. Then I can't believe we went this long on this story.
This is ridiculous.
It's a beautiful story.
It's a beautiful moment. I love the world. I love humanity.
Oh, when they bring us stuff like this, it's like, thank you.
I just want to thank the Academy.
I want to thank the Academy for sending all their people to that island and having this happen. Truly fantastic. In a statement Friday, the Bahamas Ministry of Tourism apologized and put the blame squarely on the shoulders of the organizers. That would be Ja Rule, by the way, and the credit card guy.
Are they really the organizers, or do they get fucked?
They're the organizers, man. Dude, you don't put your name on something and not pay attention to what's going on. You just don't.
Well, clearly, they didn't.
Let's see. Where is it? The production. Who is this guy again? Oh man, never mind. It's too late. What did they say about his thing? The formerly lauded credit card company. The CEO of the formerly lauded credit card company and Ja Rule, and apparently that model.
Although that to me says trustworthy right there.
That's trustworthy. That's like, oh man, your credit card company is lauded. Formerly, what? What was that last word? Formerly. So I'm gonna play this out with the closing statement here. Hundreds of visitors to Exuma. I mean Exuma. Okay, Exuma. The place is called Exuma. Okay, Exuma. I mean, is that not the best? Okay. Exhume, as in dig up.
Did this really happen?
Yes. You know what? I assumed it happened, but this could be a giant false flag.
This could be an inside job false flag.
This is distracting us from the Aaron Carter story that we covered last show.
Oh, yeah, that he has eating problems.
Right. That's probably, they don't want us to think about that. They're distracting us with this story. They're protecting Aaron Carter. Hundreds of visitors to Exuma were met with total disorganization and chaos. The organizers of FRY recently asked the Ministry of Tourism for support for their private event. The Ministry of Tourism is not an official sponsor, so that means that when the guy was walking around with the megaphone saying, like the government and stuff, you can't blame this one on the government, folks. This isn't the government's fault.
This is all garbage.
Hey, you know, it's wonderful. It's a wonder what the free market can do. The Ministry of Tourism is not an official sponsor of the FRY Festival. Given the magnitude of this undertaking, the MOT lent its support, as we do with all international events. We offered advice and assisted with communications with other government agencies. Oh, the government was involved. I stand corrected. Oh, good. I'm glad about that.
Wow!
Because I don't want to have to entirely blame the flea market.
The flea market. You can't just blame the flea market.
I don't want to. Maybe if they had a flea market, people would have been happier. The event organizers assured us
they would have had something to eat.
Right, exactly. The event, they'd have probably some
hot dogs.
They'd have hot dogs, and they'd have Fasnacht? Those things. Those things are awesome, man.
Fasnacht?
Oh, you don't know what Fasnacht are? That must be a Pennsylvania Dutch thing. They're like sugary bread thing. It's awesome stuff, man.
You mean fried dough?
It pretty much is what they are, yeah. The event organizers assured us that all measures were taken to ensure a safe and successful event. How about when you saw that they were bringing in FEMA tents that formerly lauded meant something more than just a phrase. I think we're done here. I think we're done. And if you guys would like us to do more breaking news Lozilla stuff, let us know in the comments. And
absolutely ridiculous.
Please like, share, comment. This video will be up on the State of Wake YouTube.
The State of Bake.
I can't get it. I'm in shock.
The State of Bake.
No, I'm not doing it. State of Bake. I'm not doing State of Bake. Not doing it because we're woke. But it'll be on the State of Wake YouTube page until we are working on getting a Napaw TV YouTube page. And and then once we have that, then we'll put stuff there. And do you have any last closing remarks for our studio audience, Bodhi? And I'm sorry I couldn't engage with the comments, but I was concentrating on the article. Do you have...
That's it.
That's it? All right. And we'll see you. We may possibly be doing a show, full show tomorrow. Not 100% sure of that. I'm sure Bodhi isn't either. So it's possible, though.
Nothing is sure right now, Paul.
No, absolutely.
Formerly lauded showmanship is now.
Is now our thing. It's now our thing. Well, at least we were once lauded, which that's probably an exaggeration of truth in and of itself. But
yeah.
All right, we're going to end the show here, folks. We'll see you next whenever, and we hope that you enjoyed this breaking news story from Lozilla.
Thanks for watching.